Thanks so much, George, for your kind invitation. It is for me an honor to be here virtually, unfortunately, but I hope in the next future you can organize something here. It is a wonderful place. You can see from my window the Mediterranean Sea, and it is a wonderful place. The nature is very, very fantastic here. Today I am the pleasure, thanks so much for this second invitation. For me, for my research group, it is very important to have the opportunity, this prerogative to come present our recent results obtained in a blend, in a combinatorial, in a platform of different fields. Very interesting to study this particular virus and its epidemics dynamics. But in our opinion, these tools, these models, could be very important to analyze, to capture, to better analyzing the complexity of the studies by optimizing models, when the complexity of the tools, the mathematical tools involved, and in particular the complexity of the environment studied, presenting some discontinuity of the function, not differentiable optimization problem, and so on, the presence of bias and noise, we can try to introduce some meta-heuristic approach, very, very close to possible modeling in machine learning and in deep learning, when a genetic algorithm will be involved, to combine the optimization problem and in particular some behavior of certain dynamical systems. You can follow my first explanation in the direction of the complexity of the observation of some natural phenomena. And for all mathematicians, it's very important to observe. It is important in particular for the physicists, but the observation is fundamental to better modeling the problem, involving a combination, a rational combination of different tools to better model the problem. In particular, in the today presentation, I will organize some results already published on operational research perspective. This is the first study already published in this direction. But today I will present you some new results in this context, in particular for that concern the combination between meta-heuristic algorithms and our optimization model. The context of analysis is the problem of coronavirus, obviously, but it is important to explain this aspect. All problems where epidemics or dynamics distribution of such phenomena can be optimally modeling by this combination of. This is a first study in this direction, and we will present, I have the pleasure to present the IPAI scheme based formulation, and in particular the introduction of an optimization problem with the tentative of modeling a dynamic model with crowding effect, that In particular, in this moment of the pandemic evolution by coronavirus, the crowding effect, in particular for that concern, the diffusion of the variants named Omicron, is a sociological, a socioeconomic effect particularly in evidence in this last month. And this situation that we hope will be stopped in 6 1 year, in 1 year, but in the future, unfortunately, could be come back. And we are trying to introduce some modeling that can be worked by trying in forecast the evolution, the dreadful evolution of this terrible situation. The present study convene some new aspect of the theory of IPAI scam for solving, in particular in the first part of my talk, for solving some epidemiological problem in presence of this particular effect named crowding. This is a simple outline of our presentation. The architecture of IPAI scam in particular consists in four steps. The first one, we will analyze the impact of variation in the order of PADE approximants for state variable or resulting cast function has been studied. Why PADE approximants? Because we will see that in presence of some rational function can be important to introduce the approximant in terms of PADE, very important in complex analysis to analyze the convergence of the solution. In the last year, some important paper in the literature introduced this tool. It is not very easy, not very smart tool, PADE approximant, but very useful to analyze in terms of Taylor series, some truncant Taylor series to analyze the better convergence of some solution. These methods can be important also to solve some dynamical system in terms of convergence of the solution. And in our context, we will start from these PADE approximants to begin to introduce in rational way some potential application also in terms of artificial intelligence. But this is an ongoing study, a seminal tentative in this direction, but we are confident that in the next future could be obtained some interesting results also in this direction. The second step, we will introduce a comparative study of the performance of some meta-heuristic algorithms and formulated in terms of unconstrained optimization problem from a particular optic of view, in terms of hybrid evolutionary optimizer and for better analyze the complexity of our point of view. The third step, the strength of our mathematical programming combined with meta-heuristics for solving these complex epidemiological models will be highlighted. And the IPAI scam's convergence speed will be compared in terms of some non-standard finite difference structure. This is the step of our study where we can introduce some potential evolution studies in the direction of intelligence, artificial intelligence. This is the novelty of this talk with respect to the results that were already published 2 months ago on operational retrospective, and we hope can be a potential platform of studies that in the next months can give to me and my group some satisfactory results. We will start from the model formulation in terms of epidemics issue that represents the first step of our research interest. In our problem, we consider the whole population denoted by capital N and some compartment very interesting as in terms of state variable. These compartments are the susceptible humans denoted by a capital S of T, infected humans IT, and the recovered humans RT. Four important variables are fundamental for the building of our model. With me is the recruitment rate or mortality rate of humans, Vita, the force of infection. With this ratio, we will represent the growing effect in a population in terms of the force of infection in a certain population, and with gamma, the rate of recovery due to immunity or vaccination. This SIR model can be very important also in terms of simple dynamical system to analyze the beautiful situation when the rate alpha increases continuously. How we are in particularly in Italy in the last 4 weeks and in particular in the last month. The rate of active cases, we know that is elevated, in particular thanks to the Omicron variant. And we know that there is a direct relationship between the growing factor and active patients of coronavirus. This is important to better controlling the parameter alpha. In other words, is by this parameter it is. We can try to check, to give, to better analyze the behavior of the dynamics of a coronavirus disease. And obviously, this is its potential management of this particular situation. This is the flow diagram of coronavirus model with growing effect. We see the dynamics between all the compartment that were introduced. And this is the dynamical system with the time derivative and the building of our SIR model. Very classical, but absolutely new. But following the classical rule that the researcher which work normally usually work in the frame of epidemics problem are trying to build. But the real, it is important to introduce the analysis briefly, the analysis of the model, because our is a model robust in terms of results, and it is important starting from this robustness to introduce the transformation by Padé approximation to prepare this model to find some solution in terms of meta-heuristics algorithm, because this dynamical system can be analyzed starting from a classical approach to giving some evidence in terms of quantitative results, or also in terms of the interpretation for that concerns the qualitative analysis. But our prominent, our main research interest is to analyze the mathematical potential of this model in terms of a transformation into the new language for possible application in terms of machine learning algorithm, or more simple, some meta-heuristic application. For that concern, the dynamical system in the classical point of view, we can test the positivity and the boundness of this dynamical system in terms of the feasible region of the system defined by this capital H. We have this feasible region, and we obtain this the first theorem very following a classical approach in this context. The solution SIR belong to the third dimensional dimension of the system are positive at any time given non-negative initial condition, but is very very easy to understand. The boundness in the is clarified by the content of the theorem 2. The solution of our system are bounded, and the proof is very automatic. And after we obtain the equilibria of this, we have two equilibria. The disease-free equilibrium, and most important, the endemic equilibrium with the steady state of our dynamical system. We obtain in a closed form our solution, and the aspect more important, and the definition of the reproduction number of the model. This reproduction number can be used in all epidemic issue where there is this potential growing effect, very similar to the situation that we are living. We obtain also some local stability analysis with the theorem 3. The system is locally stable related to the various free equilibrium point if the reproduction number is strictly less to 1, and unstable if the reproduction number is greater to 1. The point E0 obviously is locally asymptotically stable, and this is a consequence of the study of the our Engen values obtained by the Jacobian of our system. We obtain also the positive endemic equilibrium of the system or locally stable when the reproduction number is greater to one, but it is obvious. And our classical analysis is completed, introduced also the Ruth-Hurwitz criteria for the second order dynamics of our system, and we confirm the local stability at E star for a reproduction number strictly greater to one. This proof completes the analysis concerning the local stability of the model and showing the robustness of our dynamical system. But the now is important to try introducing the evolutionary Padé approximation following the classical rule concerning the EPI scheme into the point of view related to the coronavirus issues. The first stage of our transformation, starting from our dynamical system, is construct an equivalent optimization problem by modeling the system of governing equation in terms of Padé approximation. After this, this approximation is execute the optimization task by implementing, here will be introduced the meta heuristics in terms of differential evolution algorithm. I try to start from the differential evolution because it is, in my opinion, not only the most important, the most used algorithm in this direction, but also the most useful algorithm for that concern this research tentative to combining this aspect related to our dynamical system a certain characteristics of our optimization problem. The main goal of our research is to obtain a global optimum solution, and in this direction will be introduced the non-stagnated Nelder-Mead simplex algorithm that usually is introduced for analyze the convergence of variant of a simplex search-based Nelder-Mead method in the classical literature in this context. The unconstrained minimization objective function phi of x will be highly nonlinear, and the aspect, mathematical aspect, more important at that this function, this objective function, may contain discontinuities and in particular several local optima. Will be analyzed the two orders, will be denoted by capital N of me. For that concern, the Padé approximation increase, and some results will be obtained in a closed form by the use of differential evolution algorithm. These are the five steps of our formulation. We start from the approximating the state variable by Padé approximation. We converting with conversion of each governing equation with a residual function. We handle the initial condition studied as a problem constraints. we will study some not differentiable optimization problem, and to obtain a constrained optimization, we will use some penalty function for obtaining a constrained global optimization in presence of some constraint, potential constraint with respect to some real phenomenon, but that must be modeled in our context. The global mean optimum solution of the resulting unconstrained optimization problem will be analogous to the solution of our model. Briefly, the most important step of this approximation by Padé rational function. First, we approximate our state variable of our dynamical system, SIR, by Padé rational function of some order. And will be introduced some polynomial function related to the time variable of the degree m and n respectively. Then Padé rational approximation function of order m o n of with the, in relation of our state variable will be obtained. And by using of some coefficients A and B for each J belong to the full number, we will use some natural number, full number because also zero will be considered, we will obtain the derivative of our Padé approximation with respect to time. By this derivative, we can model our system in terms by the introduction of some real valued residual function, epsilon of S of I of R, our state variable, related to some decision vector belong to our n-dimensional space, of unknown Padé approximation coefficient for any time belong to our interval zero infinity. And in this way, we obtain the our version of the dynamical system in terms of residual function. By using the definition of derivative will be, which was introduced in the in the precedent slide. The initial condition with respect to the physical restriction is was modeled by this non-negative constraint function introduced by this capital capital H for L for all state variables considered in our dynamical system, and in this way we obtain our Padé approximation based mathematical modeling starting from this this transformation. It can be observed from equation from 7 to 10 that the residual function are in fact highly nonlinear function, and that this transform our problem in terms of highly nonlinear optimization problem. But due to the high complexity of the resulting optimization problem, now it is important to introduce some evolutionary algorithms to try to obtain some global local minima in terms of this procedure, starting from the evidence that we are in presence of an optimization, not differentiable optimization problem. We start from a large positive real number and Px be the function of the following relation. We obtain our minimization, a constrained minimization problem with our function phi of x. This is the order of our algebraic function in terms of residual function. And this the use of this Cartesian product between among the this large positive real number and p of x related to our Padé approximation. Why it is important to introduce the differential evolution global search optimizer? Because differential evolution algorithm is, we know that is a population-based random search algorithm that start with a randomly generated set of several solutions. And we know that differential evolution is a method that optimizes a problem by iteratively trying to improve a candidate solution with regard to a given measure of quality. These methods are commonly known as meta-heuristics, as they make few or no assumption about the problem being optimized, and can search very large space of candidate solution. In this direction, differential evolution is normally used for multidimensional real valued function, but does not use the gradient of the problem being optimized, which means that differential evolution does not require that the optimization problem to be differentiable. And normally, this type of algorithms is used on optimization problem that are not even continuous, are noise, change over time, that represents the natural situation that we are observing in particular in this moment of the epidemics curve. The iteration process of this differential evolution algorithm continues until a present criterion is satisfied. In this moment, we obtain the global solution. And our model was shown that this step was obtained in a closed form. Some geometrical evidence of this procedure. The standard differential evolution algorithm uses only three parameters that are the population size k belong to capital N, the crossover rate, CRK, that belong to a closed interval 0, 1, and the differential weight xi, the difference rate xi, that it is important to obtain our potential solution in this search space, where we are present some candidate solution that are in practice are agents in terms of differential evolution that can move in this geometric space. This geometric view of differential evolution give us the opportunity to capture the real importance of the possible location of our solution in terms of movement of this this candidate solution that must be selected by our algorithms. In terms of this iteration mechanism to solve our procedure. Several studies already present in the specific literature describe the classical differential algorithm in terms of this algorithm that is can be found in the on web. And starting from the traditional differential evolution algorithm that was introduced in the literature in 2005 in the famous book edited by Springer, by Price, Thorne and Lampinen, which introduced and explained in detail the study of this important algorithm named differential evolution. To minimize what are the steps of this searching optimization procedure? To minimize a function of the form of phi, classical vectorial function, the sequence of operation are four: the initialization, the parameters k, cr, and c are set. A positive integer fixed the maximum number of iteration. The iteration counter tau is start from zero. A population of k solution is generated randomly with an uniform distribution. The k solution, the candidate solution, are evaluated, and the best solution is the arg mean of our function. The second step is the iterative process, starting from tau equal to tau plus one. We fix the target solution, choose mutually with distinct indices. We introduce a mutant vector U, this one. A mutant vector U within a Cartesian product between the distance with consider two possible solutions. And after the application of a uniform discrete crossover probability, we update the best solution by this iteration. The last step is the optimum results in terms of the best solution CAD, which represent the optimum solution of our problem. That can be obtained only when the termination criterion, the third step, will be found. This termination criterion, in our opinion, represents one of the aspects that we are going to analyze to start from this model to try to introduce a new genetic algorithm in terms of deep learning approach to better the mechanism that the classical mechanism that till now normally the differential evolution algorithm work starting from also the results was already obtained in this study. What was the role played by the NetherMeet simplex local optimizer? We know that the NMS algorithm is a gradient-free optimization method which normally is used for end medicinal problem in presence of some end simplex convex hull points. In this optic, the vertices in, starting from a geometric point of view are ordered from the best to the worst according to these sequences. At each iteration, the centroid of all the worst vertices is computed. In these terms, the operation of reflection, expansion, and contraction about capital G are used, the centroid, are used to replace the worst vertex. This method is normally used in terms of operational research and is very elegant approach in the classical operational research problem. These are the four operation of this method: the reflection by this function, the expansion, the contraction outside, the contraction inside, the two moment, and the shrink function. The typical values of these parameters in the original studies that was involved are this one. These are the our number which was involved in our problem. And this is the schematic flow chart of this Nelder mid simplex local optimizer, which was obtained starting from results obtained by this author and published in a not very cited journal, the Pakistan Journal of Science, but the method was implemented in our study, starting from this seminal idea, and the first stage results obtained into this by this this paper published in 2017. What are the most important results was obtained? We conduct a twofold study of the solution obtained by this EPI scheme. And the principal objective of our work is was to obtain the semi-analytical solution of the considered model with a certain accuracy, preserving the vital properties of the dynamics of the model in the optics of the standard approach of the SIR model. But what was really important was that the global minimum value of the objective function defined by the equation this problem, the minimization problem, was the unconstrained minimization problem introduced precedently. This objective function is zero, which corresponds to a global optimal point X star. And keeping in mind that the positivity of our residual function obtained by the introduction of the Padea approximation and our penalty function P of X, capital P of X, we obtain this final step condition, and our equation in correspondence of this global minimum value, obviously the equation residual equation epsilon V is equal to zero, and implies that X star is the exact solution of the governing equation in terms of our dynamical system. But what was important is the guaranteeing of the initial condition mentioned structure preserving properties are accurately satisfied. Some remarks about these results. The optimal values of the Padé approximation coefficients were found under various options of over the Padé approximation with respect to the endemic and the disease-free equilibrium states were introduced by our dynamical system. To validate the performance of the proposed hybrid differential evolution optimizer, we explore the interpolating strength of Padé approximants, considering three dimensions of order of degree of the rational function will be involved in this modeling process. Order 4, 5, 6, to approximate each state variable, the three state variable were involved in our dynamical system to obtain the endemic as well the disease-free equilibrium. This is the analysis related to the robustness of our approach related starting from some statistical measure, best mean and standard deviation of the optimization results, starting from 20 independent runs. We obtained the mean convergence curves of 2000 iterations of this optimization crossing, considering the three order degree 4, 5, 6 approximants, and these are the results in terms of robustness. The optimization results were presented and analyzed as consistency of Niedmelder differential evolution algorithm demonstrated by computing best mean a standard deviation of final optimal values. The accuracy of the solution was assessed by the fact that how small phi of x optimal was found. The convergence speed of this method was assessed by many iterations to achieve a threshold value denoted by these new results in literature. The effectiveness of the proposed method is justified by comparing the obtained solution with multiple modern meta-heuristics. This aspect is very interesting related to the meta-heuristic. I think, George, that I have only 5 minutes. It's true?
Yes, you still have 5 minutes.
Briefly, we present a comparison between the optimization results was obtained in terms of some modern meta-heuristics under the same settings of population size and some peculiarity of our model. The meta-heuristic used for comparison was listed here. These meta-heuristics are the best actually in the literature. Our our performance comparison with our algorithm was give us some important confirmation of the robustness of our model. We summarize this performance comparison with respect to the three order solution order degree introduced by our Padé approximation. We can see that only in one case for that concern the teaching learning meta-heuristic method TLBO We have results that confirm that the convergence speed of our method is better than all of the competition, except for the six-order solution of where TLBO was better than our method. With respect to the other, our model and methods are is competitive with good performance in terms of solution and the speed of mechanism behavior. I tried with the conclusions. The main focus of our research was the formulation of how this COVID CA model as an equivalent global optimization problem. Our main scope was create a blend of mathematical programming, epidemiology, and metaheuristics. And the first contribution is related to the theory of optimization, involved two innovations. The first one, the formulation of a new general order Padé approximation for the building of a global optimization problem, preserving some very important properties as positivity, boundedness, and stability. This generalization is really new in literature and allows varying or adjusting the orders of Padé approximants for to obtain the solution more accurately. And the second one innovation was the formulated optimization problems complexity varied not only the use of deterministic optimizers, but also some new metaheuristics. Also in terms of speed about the to solve the problem, we note that the faster convergence speed is very, very competitive. And this is important to introduce this model also for to solve some practical problem, some practical evidence starting from the dreadful of the epidemics emergency in our world. Thanks so much. This is a list of references. Thanks so much for your attention. And thanks again, dear George, for your kind invitation.